Hello, science queers! Today, 7th of February, is the unofficial day of the periodic table. This year is extra special because 2019 is the actual international year of the periodic table. I should know because I'm Dr. Lana Vully, the science queen.
Science queers!
My fellow science queers, today I'm going to spill the tea on the story of the periodic table of the elements. To do this, we're going back some centuries to praise those who were right and to expose those who were just stupid.
It was Democritus, a Greek thinker, who worried about the divisibility of the matter 4 centuries before Christ. He imagined there existed an indivisible particle, which he named atom, in a fine display of originality, since atom means indivisible in Greek. But the poor unfortunate soul was not very popular, and in the 5th century, Empedocles invented that 4 elements rubbish, that is, earth, fire, water, and wind. Empedocles believed that they mixed to form all the substances of nature. Girl, please. And the great Aristotle put the icing on the cake with the 5th element. No, not the film, but the ether, which was supposed to form the stars.
2 centuries later, the Arabs spread alchemy like an STI during their conquests. But despite everything, the search for the utopian philosopher's stone allowed the discovery of hundreds of compounds and some elements.
Even so, it was not until the 17th century that the praiseworthy chemistry was born. At the beginning of the next century, Doberiner, a German chemist, noticed that there were some groups of elements with similar properties. Nowadays, we call those groups, well, groups. Around mid-century, Newlands, an English chemist, observed that the properties of the elements were the same every 8 elements if he ordered them by atomic weight. He invented the periods, but the idea was rejected because it stopped working after calcium. Finally, in 1869, Meyer and Mendeleev thought, separately, that the different periods could be different in length. Unfortunately for Meyer, Mendeleev published it first, so he is the official author of the current table.
The periodic table allows predicting the properties of any element, known or unknown, depending on their place in it. Moreover, these properties tend to change gradually, there we say, periodically, from one end to the other of the table. Few scientific systematizations can compare to this.
Science queers!
And this, my fellow science queers, was the story of the periodic table. And remember, I like an eggplant as much as the next queen. Cyanide later!